Very important question, and it's very important to clarify this actually. In the whole world, there's no shortage of food. The only problem is distribution of food is the problem. Everywhere, every country, even in every village, there's a food enough for every people. What is lacking is the modern mechanism to distribute this available food to every individual. That became the problem for all the food, you know. So that we have to educate the people to go seasonal, eat fresh season food.
Yeah, I know.
A lot of natural foods we have. Vegetables, herbs, and yeah, I mean, it is always possible. And now because I worked in the farm for some years, and I also have experience in the market, I was seeing a lot of change in last few months itself. So which means we still have a lot of years, and it's always possible. I can foresee that happening on the target here. Very important question, and it's very important to clarify this actually. In the whole world, there's no shortage of food. The only problem is distribution of food is the problem. Everywhere, every country, even in every village, there's a food enough for every people. What is lacking is the modern mechanism to distribute this available food to every individual. That became the problem. If we look at this market, we have a lot of vegetables, really a lot of vegetables. And we do throw a lot of this fresh, edible vegetables. We still have a consumable value. So which means, more than this market, we have so many foods produced, vegetables produced in different part of the country here in Bhutan. And this, if these vegetables can reach this market, we don't have a shortage. The problem so far is, because some of these, you know, the market players, key players, they didn't consider to put the local producers into the play, and then the marketing system was a little bit diluted, and that is why, you know, we, some of these, you know, market players like wholesalers, the retailers, the importer, they were relying heavily on the exporter from India side, because it was then more easier. You know, it just carries by the truck here. It's just like the, you know, kind of office work. You know, you send the dump. You know, it just comes here, and then they distribute. That was how it was built so far. But then, having that rupee crunch, it's not an economic crisis in Bhutan. Frankly, it's a small rupee shortage. Simply, it's a rupee shortage. Rupee is the Indian currency. It's not Bhutan currency, my goodness. And it's not an economic crisis. It's a small rupee shortage problem in Bhutan. And it's a big blessing that the India is giving to Bhutan. Especially for a farmer like myself, which means if this supply chain from India is broken by the shortage of rupees, we have all the reasons and meanings and the opportunity to create our own, you know, market system from farm, which is so fresh to this market, and which is why it is happening so far. You know, if you look at, if you could have come, you know, last time, you could have found many of Indian products here. But luckily, if you look at right now, it's all local produce we have. And more importantly, you're at the peak of the season, and all these things you see here, some of these are over the years, you know, produced. And it is really fresh, so nice, no preservative, so natural. I can't imagine, you know. And it's a blessing for us. And organic farming, yes, naturally, I mean. We are not really, again, going for organic farming. We are going for natural farming. Okay, they are not much different. The concept is basically same. In the organic farming, maybe there are a lot of, you know, techniques and technologies that you might have to use in production of food. Such like, it's like a biodynamic farming. You know, you are not allowed this, or sometime in the organic farming, you are again, you know, allowed with some, you know, chemical fertilizers to supplement or things like that. But in the natural farming, you just grow natural. You know, no chemicals, any kind of shape, you know, or whatever. It's very natural, I mean. So there's a little difference there. So basically what natural farming does is, you just sow the seed, grow it with, even with the weeds, and that weeds become the protection for the insects, you know, of liking those crops we sow. and then that is very natural way of managing the farm. But organic farming, maybe again you have to use some of the biological control, like the biopesticide. In natural farming, no, we never use that. Yes, natural farming. Well, it is a very serious issue. Not only in Bhutan, it's a global issue. Nobody likes farming. They all want to go to the town cities, play video games, you know, sleep day and night, and they do not know what is being produced, what they are eating, you know, basically. And it is a very serious problem for the world itself. Yeah? Yes, certainly Bhutan is a part of the world, and we have this problem, a bit of problem. And yes, we have a very small land already. And if we can utilize all this arable land in Bhutan, which is like 11%, then we are enough. But the problem is we do not have, like I was saying, all those farmers we have are old people, they are not educated people, they are not energetic as much as myself, you know. They are not so inspired by farming like myself, which means the production scale so far is less. So far. And if there are people who wants to go back to the farm and work as a farmer like myself, I should really tell them that that's the place where everybody should go, frankly. Because there you are, you will never know what you're with, actually. You are everything of your own. I don't know how to put it into words, actually. But it's in the town, I can just put it. You watch TV, you go to Bido, you know, maybe you just hang out, maybe some whatever, I don't know. But it doesn't really count for me. But if you are really human being, if you really have this character of humanity, if you want to be a very humble person, then be a farmer, go back home. It doesn't mean you have to be, you are under captivity there in a farm. Like myself, you know, I go to so many countries all over the world. I've been to US, I've been to Japan, I've been to so many different countries, you know. And I'm still a farmer, I go back, I come back, I'm a farmer, you know. So that is, I think, it's very enjoyable, and it's very free. It sets you very free, and if you want to active GNH, be a natural farmer, be a humble people. You know.